Hey, Professor Chi. I haven't seen you in a bit.
It's Antoine, right? Antoine. Bendele?
Bendele, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Though a Nigerian woman told me that it's actually supposed to be Baendele, like it's supposed to be like a little stop in the middle, because that's how that language works. And it initially I thought it meant born away from home, but she said it means to return home,
which is
kind of cool because this is actually not my birth name. I was born Antoine Bailey, and my dad found out that it was like, you know, a slave name, and he didn't want to keep that, so he found like a name that was more appropriate. So.
Oh my gosh, it's been so long.
It's been a while.
How are you?
I'm doing pretty well. I just published my first book. It's called Tales from Esiwan the Kishi,
and I wanted
to give that to you because we've been talking online for so long, and I haven't actually been able to give you a copy yet.
I think you put a Facebook announcement that you just published it this year, right?
Yeah, in February. I specifically wanted it to be in Black History Month. So.
That is amazing. What got you interested in this topic?
Well, it was your class, actually.
You're not just saying that because you're...
It was just because that's how I found you in the first place, because while I was researching all this stuff, I think it was like some African lecture, and then you popped up, and I was like, oh my God, that was my professor. And I was like, she would be perfect for me to like ask questions to like that. So I went to my old West LA college email, found you in there from like some lecture or some syllabus or something like that.
I think we did that for Black History Month a different year, and it was with Digital Design Studio called Tales of Timbuktu, mm-hmm. and they videotaped it, and we put it up on YouTube, and that was so much fun.
And I
so
literally
exciting.
Just found you from
I
that,
know.
And I was like, that was crazy that happened. I would come to you and just ask, like, is this right, or where should I research for this, you know, all that kind of stuff, and that's been really helpful. Because you did teach a world history class, and we did every part of the world, but you were very specific on the African continent, and you even called yourself, what was the term?
Africanist.
I had never heard that term before, like in any history class I ever had. No one ever like claimed. I was like, who is this woman? Why is she calling herself this? But also the types of portions of Africa that you were discussing mm-hmm. were not the ones usually highlighted in high school or even in university to an extent.
We actually ran into each other at the Apple store.
Yeah, when I was working there. I think in like my third year of being there, you were deciding between an iPad mini and like a full-size iPad for your classroom.
Yeah, so tell me about the book.
So I went ahead and did research, particularly in this one. This one was based on Angola, the people of Angola, pre-colonial. I wanted to do a folklore that has not been in the media at all. And the story behind this is that it's like a vampire kind of guy, like charmer on the front, but has like a hyena on the back that's gonna like eat you. That already has a plot in itself. Like the folklore has a plot, but it didn't exist anywhere except in a D&D book in like a paragraph. So I was like, let me just do it myself.
That's amazing. And I understand that you're self-published?
Yes. All through Kindle, CreateSpace, Ingram Spark. And Audible and iTunes, because it's an audiobook as well. Completely forgot to mention that. It's an audiobook as well.
Oh my gosh, that is fantastic. Yeah. And I think I understand that this book is going to be used in high schools?
Yeah. It's being taught in a world curriculum, world literature. So she just did Greek mythology, the teacher who was teaching it, and then like her following week was African, and she used my book as an example.
Oh, that's amazing.
And that's exactly what I wanted to do. I kind of wanted to trick people to be like, oh, look at fantasy. Who wants to? You're learning about African history. Ha ha.
That is amazing. I think one of the things I really appreciate about you is even after you graduated, after you found me on Facebook, mm-hmm. is this relationship we've had, and you've asked more questions.
Oh, yeah.
Probably since graduation than when you were actually a student of mine. So I appreciate that. It kind of reminds me that we faculty do make a difference sometimes with our students, and even if we don't see it right away, like all those years afterwards, it starts to show up, and it's amazing how you persevered and you're continuing your education and creating amazing.
It takes
literature.
Time. It's not. It was the trust the process is the term, right? You know, you can't just think it's just gonna happen like, oh, I took the class, now let me like go out and do that in the world. No, it takes some years, and you have to like keep at it to be able to do that.
That's amazing. And what's your next project from here on?
The next one I have, the Tales from Esiwan is a series of stuff like done within the African continent, inspired by fantasy in that. So the next one is called The First Sky Pirate, based on the Swahili coast. So
that's great.
I'm excited for that.
Oh my gosh. So you're going to go from the West African coast
to
Angola,
east. And then I have one. I'm going to do one on Mansa Musa and Timbuktu.
Oh my gosh.
So that's another one. I have
a
fictional character based on that. So it's a lot.
Yeah. I remember your class was just fantastic because we were, I think, just starting global studies. And then we had this, our class get involved, and we did all kinds of events for women's history and Asian Pacific American Heritage Month and labor history, all for global studies. And that was a pretty active class. Mm-hmm. It was, you guys were interested and engaged and constantly asking questions and That was a fun class.
Yeah, it was pretty good. I like that one.
So I'm glad you're recommending that students come back to
West
LA
to do general education in a college like this, because you don't really know what you'll end up doing. And then my university was so pricey at Cal State Northridge, so I was like, maybe I should do this. And my dad even told me to do that, but yeah. I was just so excited to go to university that I was, yeah. But it's very good to come here and start here.
Well, thank you so much for this book, and I can't wait to have you sign it for me.
Yeah, oh, of course. No, that's a given.